Hey guys, and welcome to another FaceTime with Norm. I am Norm. Welcome to episode 2 of the show. This week, I really have nothing to talk about. I'm not going to do a update status with PFW because this is just FaceTime with me. And I know PFW is kind of a part of what I do, but I don't want to always start off the show with something like that. However, this has been a very trying week, couple weeks actually, I should say, since the new staff has been put in place, and now that I guess that's fully operational. I guess my staff is fully operational. I don't know. But yeah, it's been a somewhat of a stressful week. I think I was kind of on the brink of insanity. You know, first Vego Man announces he's leaving, and then all of a sudden, you know, we have admins that don't want to be admins anymore, and just a bunch of craziness. So before I do get into questions, because we do have questions, and we have a ton of questions here from the nice people over here at CAW Underground, I just want to, of course, remind you that this the show is available for download on the forums at CAW Underground. You can go to www.theindiesource.com/CAW Underground. You can download this show and other possible audio shows that have been started. You're also watching this on, I kind of went Dusty Rhodes there for a second, if you will. If you want to follow us and continue to follow us on Twitter. It's twitter.com/CAW Underground. And of course, you can subscribe here on YouTube if you're watching this, or if you're listening to this on YouTube. You can subscribe by clicking the subscribe button, which is at the top of the page. I don't know what that was, so don't murder me for butchering whatever that was. Anyways, let's get into questions. And we're going to start with Malifesto, who asked, why do you close your eyes when we make love? Because you're hideous. You're just absolutely hideous to look at. And then when I close my eyes, I think of someone sexy like Taylor Lautner from Twilight. Yeah, that happened. Next one, we're going to go to Sky. Does he have more than that? No, that's it. Okay, so he has a few questions to ask. He asked, first question, Madden 13 worth buying if you're not hardcore about it? I would say it is worth buying both ways. If you're a hardcore Madden fan, and even if you're not a hardcore Madden fan, you should probably pick up this game. This is one of the best Maddens out today. And that's, you know, I think that was used, that saying that has kind of been overdone. You know, because every year it seemed like when Madden was released, you had one or two reviews that would sit there and would say, oh, this is the best Madden ever, and it's not really the best Madden ever. It's really like a shell of its former self. But this year, I actually enjoy all of the improvements they've put into the game with the new engine, the semi like ragdoll physics type, and no more like psychic defensive backs, you know, defensive backs that for some reason would know that you're passing the ball to that receiver and would pick it off. They have something called a read and react DBs now, so it's kind of like saying it's kind of like, you know, if a defender doesn't see the ball, they don't automatically like turn around. Like in the last game, they would just turn around and make the perfect interception when you try to throw it over them, but that doesn't happen this game. So I enjoy it thoroughly. I think it's a great game. I think it's one of the best Maddens today. What's the best NBA game out there? Right now, the NBA 2K series, because it's really the only basketball game out there right now. So I would say that live, EA Sports is doing another live, but, you know, we'll see how that comes out. I'm hoping EA actually sends me that game. Like they sent me Madden. That was great. Why do people like Adventure Time? And even though Arkane kind of summed up my answer how it was going, it is a freaking good show. It is a really good show. It's really funny, but it's a good show. That's why people love it so much, because of its randomness and everything. It's such a good show. All right. Thank you, Sky. So we're going to move on to rated questions or question. Terminator versus Chuck Norris. And I believe on the shout box, he said it was like in prime Chuck Norris. So, I would still take Terminator. Terminator is like, you know, I always felt that Chuck Norris was overrated, especially with like the internet meme. Oh, Chuck Norris can break a pubic hair in half or something like that or some shit. I can't really recall a lot of them. Or, you know, inside of Chuck Norris's beard is just another fist or some shit like that. Yeah, I'm not a big Chuck Norris fan. And I enjoyed every second of Bruce Lee kicking Chuck Norris's ass. And I believe it was like Double Dragon or something like that. I forget. It was a Bruce Lee movie that I watched recently. And I forget the name to it. It was on G4, actually. And I watched it. And I jizzed my pants so hard. I jizzed my pants. I still say Terminator. Terminator is made of... It's just machinery. There's really... You really can't beat a machine. You know? It's unless you throw water on him. But I don't even think water affected Terminator. So I take Terminator over Chuck Norris any day. I think the only person I wouldn't take over Chuck Norris would be any WWE wrestler. I'm pretty sure Chuck Norris could kick all of their asses. Thank you, Rated, for your questions. Let's go. I think UT split up his questions. I'm not sure if he did or did not. I'm not sure. Did he? No, he didn't. He didn't. Okay. Whatever. Yeah. All right. Anyways, Undamaged Threat, his question. What are your thoughts on the 10 matches of series project I'm currently working on for the CU YouTube channel, for the CAW Underground YouTube channel? If you haven't checked it out yet, you can go to if you're here already, you can check it out after watching this or listening to me ramble on about shit. But you can do that. It's 10 matches of James Dark. It's a fantastic idea. I think it's a great idea to, you know, it's kind of a DVD style presentation type deal, but I think it's one of the best things that could ever happen for CAW. And the reason why is because it's so, I think it's very innovative. I don't think anyone has ever tried to do something like this. So I like the idea, and I think it's a great idea, and I think that there should be more of these done, not just CAWs that UT owns, obviously, but I think, you know, some other CAWs, you know, people want to, or CAWs that people quite possibly want to relive some of their best moments of, you know, but, yeah. James Stark, go watch it after this. It's a very good, very interactive, and you should all watch it. All right. So thank you, UT. Going to Arkane now, who asked, his first question was, why don't you let me watch when you two make love? Because no one's supposed to know. Also, Arkane, best CAW ever, agree or agree? There is no disagreeing here, huh? So I can't disagree with this. I agree. That I can't disagree with it. It said agree or agree. I can't disagree with it. What do you think of the bloody, dirty look I'm trying to give Blood and Glory, good or bad? Okay, first of all, I just want to point out that I sounded really uneducated right there when I was reading that question. it's like someone who I like for a quick second there, it's like I forgot how to read questions. That was terrible. I don't know if I've seen the logo yet, but I'm going to go on CU and I'm going to look for it. I'm trying to think. Is that what I just... I don't know if I think I used it maybe. But I might have used it for CPW on here. Oh, no, I took it down. iHost. Yeah, we have an image hosting thing on there right now. So, do I have it up here? Do I have it up here? There it is. You know, it's not bad. I've always enjoyed, like, some of the things that Arkin has done with graphics in on CU. And he's done quite a good job with that logo. I like it. I like it a lot. I think it's a good thing. Because it represents two different things. So, you know, this show is called Blood and Glory. You know, you got to get a little... I guess you got to get a little dirty to get to that point. I don't know. I'm trying to make sense of it all. Leave me alone. Do you watch Dragon Gate? If not, watch it. Tauza or... Tozawa, is it? Is a sick cunt. I will give it a watch. I haven't watched anime in, wow, a long time. I've been trying to keep up with all the stuff that's been shown on Toonami recently. Even though I've been one of those people who go to the subsites or whatever, those anime subsites, and download like the episodes and watch them on my own time. That's how I found out about Fairy Tail, which is still going on. How is Fairy Tail still? Why is it like Bleach, Dragon Ball, Naruto, Shippuden style, DayZ, whatever. I don't understand why shows go, like, you know, the one that really shocks me, you know, Dragon Ball Z doesn't shock me as much. Bleach doesn't shock me anymore, and nor does Naruto. And I'm going to tell you why it doesn't shock me as much anymore. Because Detective Conan is still going on. Not just in, I'm not talking about just in manga form. I'm talking about, like, in episodic content. That show is still going on. It was at, like, 400 something. I think it's probably up to 500 episodes by now. I don't understand why a show needs to go on for that long. I would think by now with Detective Conan that he would have found the two people and, like, became went back to adulthood or whatever and freaking that end of show. No, he's still a kid, teenager, whatever, and still solving mysteries. He's like a crack on... It's like he's on crack and Scooby-Doo is not there to help him. I didn't know how to really sum that up. Yeah. Thank you, Arkin, for your questions. I love you. Anyways. Shinigami. Almost called him Shinigami Cunt. And I'm sorry. He's my bestest friend ever. Shinigami Fox. will you let me book the cruiserweights again? Sure, because that takes every bit of stress off of me to book anything. Because what people don't know, with OWF during season 5, I believe, season 5, season 3, what one of those two seasons, season 5. Fox. Oh, I'm sorry. Before the reboot of season 5. What had happened was, Fox asked me to book cruiserweights. Now, at the last time I let someone book a certain part of OWF, it didn't end up very well. But I trusted Fox with this because he is a level head and he needed the practice for CPW. So, yeah, I let him book the cruiserweights. I let him book the X championship division. So there you go. Which is pretty much what the cruiserweights, that's like the cruiserweight prize now, is the X championship. It's no longer like everyone. Like, I was kind of copying like TNA's version of the X division, which was no matter what weight class you were, you could still compete in that division. But it was always like high flying, lightweight, light to light heavyweights competing in that division. So it's like, okay, whatever. But sure, I don't mind. I don't care. Take some stress off of me from booking. why didn't you use Justin Blade in OWF that much? I am going to be honest with you. I had nothing for him at the time. I might have something for Justin like now, going into PFW season one. But, I had nothing for him. Like, when I got Justin, I was like, oh, he's such a cool guy. I would like to use him. And then I couldn't think of anything to really, like, put him in the middle of or start a feud with. But I might have something now. Who knows? You know, he might get put in the race for the Galactus title in PFW. Who knows? I don't want to get anyone's hopes up, so don't really expect that too soon. Why PFW? I don't know if I explained, but it was a random happenstance. No, it was really random. PFW was something I created on TEW, and I just wanted to bring the name over. I mean, I used WWC for part of a season, and I really didn't want to go back and use anything old. I wanted to do something fresh, something new. So PFW, Power Fist Wrestling. There you go. Cookie, may I have? Sure. You can have a cookie. Hi. Hi. How you doing? You good? You wash your ass? I hope you wash your ass. Because we don't want no stinky ass people around here. What's up? Not much. You know, just black guy things. So, here's my number. So, call me maybe. Maybe. I might. You know. Giggles. Anyways, thank you. Thank you, Fox. Foxy Smoxy. Foxy. I'm going to come up with a nickname. That's very foxy. Are you a brony? No. Don't lie. You're all about Fluttershy. Okay. I know the origin of this. And I'm just going to probably cross off the rest of the questions. Because the other question here. But I have never watched My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. So that answers that last question that I just crossed off. But I've never watched My Little Pony. I've never watched that show. And apparently this is a thing now. Like, I feel so old, but this is a thing. And I've never... It hasn't caught on with me, so... Yeah. I actually went and Googled, and Urban Dictionary, like, term came up, and it was like, men who love My Little Pony usually are bisexual or whatever. I was like, oh! So, people who are almost, who are half homosexual and all homosexual watch this show. Oh, okay. That's what they call themselves. I'm not going to watch the show now. Thank you very much. Doctor Who new season psyched. I haven't watched Doctor Who. I've seen a couple episodes. I haven't kept up with it like everyone else. So I'm sorry. I can't say that I'm really psyched, but I will try to watch the new season. Actually, I want to get Netflix back so I can actually watch the whole thing from like episode one. I guess David Tennant's era on up to Matt Smith's. So I hope that I don't miss anything. I think they're like hour episodes, something like that. I might give it a try. Torchwood or Doctor Who? I don't think I've ever watched Torchwood. So I would have to give it to Doctor Who. Another show to Netflix. There you go. If they have it on Netflix. Inspector Spacetime. I don't even know what that is. I don't know what that... God, what the hell is going on? I'm so out of touch with the internet. How's your mom doing? All right, I guess. She's living for the time being. Until I cut out her heart, sell it on the black market, you know, voodoo things. Yeah. Thank you for all your questions. I also want to thank everyone for tuning in. Sorry I didn't have anything like rant or whatever worthy for you to listen to start off the show, but maybe next time. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel here. More things. If you haven't seen the PFW preview match, it's up. Also, the James Stark, 10 matches of James Stark with a bonus match as added to it. So it's like the 11 matches of James Stark. Go watch that. Watch the PFW preview match between Angelic Diablo and Hank Wilson, which shows off the new digs for PFW. And I just kicked my mic stand. That's cool. And also follow us on Twitter. Again, twitter.com/CAWUnderground. Come visit the forums. Come visit the site at www.theindysource.com/CAWUnderground. Until next time, I'm Norm. And in the words of a old friend of mine, stay cool. Or was it be cool? It was one of those. Good night, everybody.